Ever since I was a child, I've loved automobiles. My father drove a V8 Dodge, big old shiny wheels. To him it was just transport with little to endear. But that old car would set the course for me throughout the year. Bumper to bumper, we love them old cars. Be it Ford or GM or be it a Mopar. People, power and passion, you know that is our deal. So tune into our TV show with Rusty at the wheel. Is your wallet empty? Are you broke?
All right, Alex, g'day and welcome to Bumper to Bumper. How are you going?
Yeah, good.
Now, we're here at the 2017 Tough Lift Van Nationals. You've got your XF panel van here. Mate, great looking car.
Thanks.
Now, you've come all the way from Tasmania and you brought your car over as well, so that's a fantastic achievement. What was the car like when you first got it?
Everything was XF. It was white, a lot of dents in it, a little bit of rust, not as much as other cars. Had a 250 Crossflow free on the tree in it, and that's basically really it.
Where'd you find the car? Did you find the car in Tassie?
Yeah, I found it on the east coast in a little town called Fingal.
Yeah.
In Tasmania, we got it for $300.
Oh, that's cheap.
Yes, it was, and now I've built it up.
Sitting in a paddock?
No, someone's backyard.
Oh, okay. What have you actually done to this car to restore it? Obviously, you've done some rust repairs. What were some of the major rust issues in the car?
There was pinholes up between the roof on the gutter.
Yeah.
It was being sideswiped, and rust between where the top canopy welds onto the ute part, and that's really it.
You've done all this. You've done the majority of work this with your dad and yourself as well.
Yeah, I done 98% of it, and my dad's done about the rest of it. Yeah.
How'd you go putting in the 302 Windsor in the car?
No, there was no problems. Just have to change engine mounts, obviously, for V8,
yeah. And
modify the gearbox crossmember for the C4. It was all pulled down when I bought it. There was nothing. The cam was stuffed, the lifters were stuffed. I had to buy a new one from the States. Bought rebuild kit, and that's really it. Rebuild it from that standard engine, and that's really it.
How do you know so much about restoring cars and working on cars?
Well, I learnt it all off my dad. He's a qualified mechanic. I've been around cars my whole life. So,
and what were some of the challenges you had to rebuild this car then?
I had gearbox problems. I bought three of them and they're all stuffed.
Yeah.
So I've pulled my dad's gearbox out just to get it here. I had carby problems and regulator problems.
So when did you finish the car?
Finished it a couple weeks before the Nationals.
And that was your aim, to get it here for the Nationals?
Yep. Yeah.
You've done a top job to actually do that. What got you into panel vans, being such a young fella?
Just liked them. I liked the older style.
So your dad's inspired you to actually get into a panel van, I suppose?
Yeah, he gave it to me, so I can't just give it away. So I wanted to build it up. I want to build it up more now, after seeing all these cars.
Actually, going to car shows, you raise a very good point about it. Gives you ideas about inspiring you to do more things to your car that you want to do. So what are some of those things you want to do?
I'd like to put side pipes on it, deck the back out with carpet, cupboards and all that stuff, bubble windows, some stainless on the bonnet, and that's really it at the moment.
I'm going to say, you're probably born 40 years too late then.
Yeah, I was.
You've just got it together. You're still tinkering with some of the things just to iron out some of the issues with it?
Yeah, I need, after this, all of my bad dad's car parts are getting taken off it, and then I have to buy them all of them and other good stuff.
All right, Alex, so I want to say, great to see such a young fellow getting into the Van Nationals and enjoying yourself and coming all the way from Tasmania to Victoria at Port Ferry to bring your car across. So that's a credit to yourself. So thank you very much for being on Bumper to Bumper. Well done, mate.
Thank you.
Well done. Cheers. And say goodbye. Say goodbye.
Bye.
Tanya, we're in a very special car here. First time I've actually been in a Porsche, so it's a privilege for me to be in a Porsche. What is it?
It's a 1957 Speedster.
And it's a beautiful looking car, very stylish car too. Obviously, this is after a famous American actor.
I think so, James Dean.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, James, very famous, died at a young age. What got you into buying this car? Because obviously this is your car.
I'm all about shape. So for me, I like the shape of this car. It's curvy, it's cute. It had little belts on the front. It had all the little things that girls like. But it's a nice little car as well, so it's a nice car to drive.
One of the things I find about yourself, because we've actually done a couple of interviews together over recent years, but the thing is that you actually do drive cars as well. You love to get into cars and drive cars as well, which is fantastic.
Yep. I've taken my 1954 Corvette out on a motorcana, taken it on the track, and also my other Corvette, the 2011 C6, I've taken that down to Sandown and done the Come Try It Day down there as well. It's just good fun.
Yeah, it is good fun. Great to see that you're into classic cars and love it, and you share the passion with Gigi as well. This particular car, driven this often?
It's one of those cars that you can really only get out in when the weather's good.
Yeah.
So it's not a winter car. We try to get it out as much as we can in the summer or in spring.
Out of all the cars you've actually got, which car really you love the most?
It's definitely the 54 Corvette. That's my favourite.
Why is that?
I don't know. It's just sexy and classy and grabs your attention. I think the first time I ever saw one, I didn't know what it was, and I just fell in love with it, and I just thought, I need to have one of those. So it was just a matter of trying to find one. So.
Another interesting question is, being involved with Gigi for such a long period of time, I suppose your appreciation for classic cars has grown over a period of time as well?
Both of our appreciation has grown. My dad was always into different cars when we were younger, so I think it came from a young age with me personally, having a dad who loved different cars and had some really cool cars back then, like Galaxy 500 and old T-Birds and things like that. So for me, it was just finding someone who also liked cars. So, and we both have grown together in our like of cars and what we like as well. So it's not, you know, all about muscle cars, it's, you know, curves and shapes and just the cool factor, I think.
That's a very good point, because cars not all just about power as well. Yeah. How can I say, they're an artistic part of sculpture as well.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm the slowest driver on earth.
Actually, I'm pretty slow too, to be honest.
So it's nice to actually just get out there and cruise.
Well, I say to a lot of people, if you're sitting, let's say if the speed limit's 100 and you're sitting on 90, at least everyone can go past and look at you, because you're looking so great, looking good yourself, but also great in the car as well.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, Tanya, well, I'll wrap it up now. I don't want to put too much pressure on you. Thank you very much for being on Bumper to Bumper.
Thanks, Rusty.
And I love your toy box.
Thank you.
Bumper to bumper, we love them old cars.
What does Scooby do? We're coming after you. You're gonna solve that mystery. I see you, Scooby Doo. The trail leads back to you. What does Scooby do?
Alright, Mickey, g'day and welcome to Bumper to Bumper. How you going, mate?
Good, mate. Yourself?
Very good. Now, we've got a 77 Bedford van, is that correct?
That's correct.
Now, not any normal van, because this is a Scooby-Doo Mystery Machine van, isn't it?
It's a close replica of an early 2000 movie.
Why have you gone this theme of Scooby-Doo? Because you must be a big kid at heart.
I guess I am. The theme originally was, I had a very talented person living with me at the time, and we thought, oh, we should buy one, paint it and sell it and make a dollar. And we bought it. It was a matte black van.
Yep.
And we thought, oh, it'd be so much easier to do an 18 van.
Yep.
And went, nah, we want the Mystery Machine. So he started it, and I said, can I just pay you? I'll pay you. I paid for the van. He was going to do the work on it.
Yeah.
I said, I'll pay you for your labour, and I'm going to keep it. I had a 13-year-old daughter at the time, so we put a seat in the back, and it was really good. I've got a couple of young ones now that just love it.
It must be a crowd pleaser, especially for the kids, because they just attract you and say, like, I've heard people all to this morning going, Scooby-Doo van, Scooby-Doo the Mystery Machine.
I see vehicles all over the place, and you look at even vehicles like Xbox,
you know. Yeah.
People want to take a photo of it. But they see my budget build and they want to stand in front and they want to get a photo with the Mr. Machine. And it means a lot more to me.
Well, it's something special because obviously we're here at the 2017 Van Nationals brought to you by Tough Lift. Yep. And we see a lot of range of different vans here. Yep. And we're talking custom, modern, regional. Yep. And this is, a movie themed type of van as well, it's grabbing a lot of attention. We've got some big dollar cars here as well.
Oh, there is, yeah. And it grabs a lot of attention wherever it goes.
How long did it take you to do the build on this car then?
It was done about 13 years ago and it probably took a couple of months to get it painted. It got repainted about 2 years ago. And as it sits now, little bit by little bit, it gets a bit more. There's a few mods coming up.
What are some of the mods?
The plan is hopefully a Gen 3, 9-inch. Oh. Just, you know, make it go a little bit better, sound a bit better and a bit nicer to drive.
Well, that'd be awesome, actually. What's it got in at the moment?
It's got a 202 with the original 3-speed manual.
Yeah, okay. And how's that chug along for, because it's a heavy car?
Yeah, they weigh about 2 tonne. Yeah, you can sit on 100, 110. It's got a nice highway gear diff in it. And it goes okay, but it's loud and noisy and, you know, there's no mod cons.
I was going to say, if you put a Gen 3 in it, you won't know yourself, will you?
No, not at all.
Yeah, it'd be nice though.
It would be very nice.
Mm. How are you enjoying the Van Nationals here at Port Ferry today?
Oh, having a ball. Had a really good time. The people running the show are fantastic and really good.
One of the things I find about the Van Nationals is about the people that you meet are actually all helping each other. Like I even saw you with Fritz's car, the movie car. So you're just helping him out, cleaning the car?
I guess I'm part of the Jaffa crew and, you know, I met Fritz 20 years ago, actually 20 years ago this year. The vans bring us together.
Yes.
It's the friendship of people like Fritz and so many others that keep us together. And whether being the Australian Van Nationals, there are people here from all over Australia, and you might only see them once a year, but they're still good mates, you know.
It's interesting, we've got people from WA, South Australia, Tasmania, Queensland, all over.
Everywhere, all over.
And the funny thing is, you know, the Van Nationals, a lot of people, panel vans are very rare in Australia as well, even though they're big, they're a small build number compared to sedans and that kind of stuff as well, but it's a different culture.
It is a different culture. I guess the culture really started back in the 70s and 80s where, you know, I guess you had the whole free love hippie sort of lifestyle. But, you know, more and more you see these guys, they've, you know, they still come, they might bring their van, but they're towing their caravan for comfort. And, you know, and I guess that's still the same people that's doing the same thing, you know, with the addition of the what we call the Millennium van, the Commodore vans, you know. It's still bringing some of the younger guys in with new vans, but there's just not enough publicity for the vans out there.
Getting back to your Bedford van and the Scooby-Doo theme, where do you get all these Scooby-Doos from?
A lot of the Scooby-Doos come from friends. A lot of people here will rock up and go, oh, I saw this at the op shop, or oh, my sister's son's outgrown Scooby-Doo and they were going to throw it away, so they bring you the toy, you know. This one guy, I've called him a trophy hunter. Because all he used to do was trophy hunt. So he found a Scooby-Doo. He sewed a trophy up to it and gave it to me. That was the, you know, trophy hunting Scooby-Doo. You know, it's good friendship.
It is fantastic. And I'm joining myself here at the Tough Lift 2017 Van Nationals. And it's a great day over the Easter period at Port Ferry. So, mate, I want to say thank you very much for being on Bumper to Bumper.
No worries.
Love you, Mr. Machine. Alan, my daughter, who's only 10, she loves Scooby-Doo and she's over it, all over it straight away, mate.
No worries. Make sure she jumps in and gets some photos.
No, I will do that. Thank you very much for that. No worries. All the best.
Thank you.
Guys, my name is John. I live on the Mornington Peninsula in sunny Macrae, which at this time of year is not so sunny. I've been singing karaoke for a long time, probably 20 years, maybe a little bit longer. Love karaoke, love getting out there and singing songs and making people happy.
You've been running all over town.
The song I'm singing today is Money for Nothing. And the reason I chose this song is really because it takes me back to my teen years when I used to listen to Dire Straits in the bedroom at home. And it's a great song, so I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
That's the way you do it. Money for nothing and your cheeks for free. Now any worker, that's the way you do it. Let me tell you, guys ain't dumb. Maybe get a blister on your little finger. Maybe get a blister on your thumb. We gotta install microwave ovens, custom kitchen deliveries. We got movies, refrigerators. We gotta move these color TVs.
Bounce if you can't even pronounce the bounce.
Oh, whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper, bounce.
Manny, g'day and welcome to Bumper to Bumper.
Hi, Rusty, how are you?
Very good. Matt, how are you going?
Good, thank you. Yeah, no, good.
Now, we're here at the 2017 Tough Lift Van Nationals. We've got a VF van with us, a modern version van. Tell us about the car first of all, Mandy. It's your car, isn't it?
It is my car and its name's Tigger, hence orange and black.
Yes.
If I had enough money to airbag it, I would, then I could bounce like Tigger does.
Now, what got you into panel vans?
Oh, gosh. I started when I was about 17, something like that.
Oh,
and,
okay.
Yeah, just had a boyfriend that we bought a panel van together, and the rest is history. Been into vanning ever since, and it's the people.
Yeah.
The people we you meet, we've been overseas vanning. We've been to America, been to four van nationals over there.
Okay.
And... yeah, love it.
Said woman, take it slow. How's vanning compared from Australia to America?
Different models, different brands, but basically the people are all the same.
Yeah, okay.
Yep, they love to get together and enjoy the passion of vanning.
Okay, that's terrific. Tell us a little bit about your car. How long have you had this one for, the VF?
I got it brand new in 2013.
Yep.
And had the canopy put on it. And I had dealer cold air induction. And we haven't done any real modifications. Oh, an exhaust, wasn't it?
Exhaust.
Haven't done any other modifications because we were waiting for the warranty to be up, which now has. And now we can't afford them.
What engine is it running?
The 6.2
litre. It's a 6.2 litre Holden, Chev, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah. And that's no slouch of a car, so this car's going to go.
I've got a sticker. It says, yes, it is fast, and no, you can't drive it.
Well, I wasn't going to ask, but I know now not to ask, don't I?
Oh, no, you can take it for a drive.
No, I wouldn't do that. No, I wouldn't do that. You picked the colour, and then Tigger came afterwards or not? Or did you pick that for the Tigger
well,
or not?
We actually saw it in the dealership, and it was a really nice metallic orange. And I thought, oh, I know I want an orange one. And then when I saw it, I went, oh, no, I don't like that orange. And then the dealer actually said, well, how about you put these black stripes on to break it up a bit? And, yeah, it looked really good. And then we decided that that looked like Tigger. So Tigger as in Winnie the Pooh's Tigger. Yes. And the rest is history. Everybody's gone and given us Tiggers. We haven't bought one.
Fantastic.
I know.
And it's good for the kids too, because obviously kids will come up to the car, have a look at it and say, oh, look, there's Tigger. They'll look at the car and say, hey, this is pretty cool stuff.
We actually let some of the kids sit on the tailgate and have a photo taken. So, yeah, they like the Tiggers.
Had a little bloke just before that didn't want to leave.
So. As long as the little bloke that wasn't leaving, not a guy who wants to sleep in the back there, right? You joined today?
It's been a really good event, well organised, and had a lot of fun. Great to catch up with all the people from all around Australia. We've even got an American here, a couple of Americans if you count Mandy, she was Australian.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're out from America, so really good.
And you guys are from?
Coonamoo.
Coonamoo. Now I've heard of that.
Where the hell's
Coonamoo? Coonamoo, yes.
8 k's west of Cobham.
Okay.
On the Murray there.
Fantastic, nice spot. You've driven all the way down?
Yep.
And in, yeah. I come across those myself as well. I wasn't happy about getting dust on my car, but look, that's another story. I mean, that's just part of the whole process.
And what car do you have?
I have a HQ Sandman.
Ah, is it here?
Yeah, chrome yellow. It'll have number plates on it, B2BTV. So if you've seen the car, give us a wave and say g'day.
Okay, we'll do.
All right, well, I want to say thank you very much for being on Bumper to Bumper. Matt, been a pleasure. Mandy,
thank
well
you
done.
Too.
The two M&Ms. Fantastic, love the Tigger, and great car, and you even got the hat to suit, so well done. All right, say goodbye.
Bye.
Hey, Rusty, do you want to hear an Ella's rhyme?
What do you mean an Ella's rhyme?
Guess what? I'm taking over the segment now.
You're kidding me.
No.
All right, we'll go for it then.
Okay. Today's poem has been written by Sonia. Old cars are the best. They're better than the rest. They squeak and creak while we swelter in the heat. They may be rust buckets to some, but they are so much fun. Heavy doors, red walls, chrome trims, and the wheels spin. The motors may smoke and run out of tune, thus bubbles may appear and the classics are still key. The V8s rev and people turn their heads. New cars are plastic, our cars are fantastic. Our cars are driven, they are not hidden.
Okay viewers, that's another episode of Bumper to Bumper, the classic car TV show that's all about
people,
power,
passion.
I'm Rusty.
I'm Ella.
Good night.
We love them old cars, be it Ford or GM or be it a Mopar. People, power and passion, you know that is our deal. So tune into our TV show.